السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I wish you a happy new Hijri year, which is starting inshallah tomorrow. And last week we were talking about the patience of the scholars who were trying to gain knowledge during the good old days. Today inshallah we'll talk about the quality of scholars who are specializing in different subjects in life, especially from the non-Arab background. Why? Because I want the rich countries today, the rich people, to recognize the contribution of such individuals and go and be loyal to their nations, their people, their countries, and rebuild it, particularly the areas in Andalusia, the good old days, the areas in the Central Asian republics, Kyrgyzstan, Kazakhstan, Afghanistan, Turkmenistan, and so on, so on, so on, so on. It produced an immense number of scholars in different subjects, whether it's scientific, theological, even the one who put the foundation of the Arabic language was from this area, was Saibawi. I'm just going to run very quickly, because this is not everything. In one of the papers, it was more than 1,200 names. Just one paper. I could not be able to bring all these names to you. But I'll run through to try to let our youth to understand the contribution of their forefathers and mothers to the history of humanity, whether they are Arabs or non-Arabs, but this today is about the non-Arabs, whether they are Muslims or non-Muslims, even allowed during that time the non-Muslim to contribute positively and heavily, whether they are actually Christian, Jews, Sabi'i, which is following the still the tradition of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Majusi, which is worshipping the flame, Yazidi, which were actually worshipping the devil or following the devil, as they call it. Anyway, first one in the theology, Imam al-Bukhari. Of course you know Imam al-Bukhari. There's no need for introduction. He was originally from, his great-grandfather was not a Muslim, was Majusi, but his grandfather was a Muslim and his father was a great scholar. And he's from Bukhara, as you understand. Imam Muslim. You know Imam Muslim? From Naisabur, which is a part of old Iran nowadays. Ibn Majah as well. These very big names. From Qazwin, which is Caspian city called Caspian and Qazwin. Okay, Imam Tirmizi as well. Okay. From Tirmidh, south of Uzbekistan. Imam Abu Dawood from Sistan, okay, which is a place between Iran and different areas, Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Central Asian Republic. Imam al-Nisa'i from a place called Nisa. Nisa is in Khorasan. Khorasan in this area, in the good old days, part of Turkmenistan. Imam al-Qurtubi. You know al-Qurtubi, Andalusia. Andalusia was contributing heavily to our history. Okay. Even Imam al-Awza'i, the Imam of Lebanon, there was a doubt about whether he was actually a slave boy from India or not, but it's from this area. Imam al-Taftazani from Samarkand, Khorasan. Imam al-Baghawi from an area called Khorasan as well. Ibn Khuzaymah, Imam Muhammad ibn Khuzaymah, al-Mughira ibn Salih ibn Bakr al-Salmi, Naysaburi from Khorasan, Imam al-Darami, Musnad al-Darami, all those great imams came from these areas to contribute positively to humanity. No race, no ethnicity, no language, but they all mastered the language of Arabic, the Arabic language, to become the imams of al-Muslimin globally. Imam Yahya al-Din, Muhammad ibn Arabi al-Hatim al-Tayl, Andalusi. Andalusia is Amazighi. Amazighi, originally not from an Arab background, but from Berber background. And his father was Marsi, and his mother was Amazighi. Imam al-Tabari, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, okay, north of Iran, Tabaristan. Imam Abd al-Qadir al-Jirjani, okay, Walid of Jirjan, Shamal Iran, north of Iran. And he is one of the founder of Ilm al-Balagha. Al-Balagha is the metaphor of Arabic language. Abu Bakr Qaffal al-Shashi, he is word, from born in Tashqand. It is next to Samarkand in Central Asian Republic. Okay, Saibawi, as I mentioned earlier, the one who founded the principles of Arabic language, he is also Persian. All right, and about the principles of Arabic language. Al-Marwazi, okay, Turkmenistan. Okay, Imam al-Bayhaqi, اللي هو أحمد بن الحسين بن علي بن موسى الخراساني, the same area, خراسان رضوي near مشهد. أبو عبد الله الحاكم النيسابوري, okay, from نيسابور, the same region. When we lived together, when we did not allow anybody to divide us on our ethnicity, even on our religion, because some of those people were not Muslim. We will come to talk about it. Whether the Jews or Sabi'i or Christian or Yazidi or whatever you call them. Imam Abu Abdullah al-Hakim al-Naysaburi, Naysabur, the same, northeast of Iran, Khorasan. Imam al-Juwayni, Abu al-Ma'ali, Abd al-Malik ibn Abdullah, ibn Yusuf ibn Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Haywa al-Juwayni, Naysabur as well, in Iran, at that time. Imam ibn Manda, okay. Abdullah ibn Muhammad, Abu Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Ishaq ibn Muhammad ibn Yahya ibn Manda al-Abdi al-Asbahani, Asfahan. Imam ibn Habban, very well known, near Afghanistan, in Afghanistan, Busti, Tamim al-Dari. صحيح ابن حبان كتاب الثقات in and 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 Imam al-Harawi, Sheikh Khurasan as well, and so on. These are the theologians and the people who put the principles of the Arabic language. So never undermine the other ethnic background, because they laid down the foundation of these principles for humanity. If we move from there to talk about other science, the science of mathematics, the science of astronomy and others. Ibn Bajjah, Abu Bakr ibn Muhammad ibn Yahya ibn Sa'igh al-Tujaybi al-Sarqasti, from where? From Andalusia. Okay. His contribution, medicine, and you talk about the principles of putting the treatment, pharmaceutical, in that. Imam al-Khawarizmi, scientific al-Khawarizmi, Abu Abdullah, Muhammad ibn Musa al-Khawarizmi, from Khawarizm, from Uzbekistan. Listen to what he did. He put the foundation of trigonometry. Trigonometry, which is ilm al-musallathat, algebra. Cartography, which is drawing the maps, okay? Mathematics, astronomy, see? Khawarizmi, from where, in this area, Uzbekistan. Abbas ibn Firnas, everybody knows him as the one who tried to fly with the two wings. But what did he do? He originally was not an Arab, was a Mazigh. Amazigh from Andalusia. Okay? Of course, he tried to fly, but his experiment has failed. But he designed the first hydraulic watch. It's number one. Number two, manufacture or the see-through transparent glass from stones, from rocks. Spectacles. Okay, the first fountain pen or ink pen, and as you understand, he was the first one who tried to fly with two wings before Leonardo da Vinci. Ibn Sina, all of you know him, contribution of Bukhara as well, Uzbekistan. He's a Tajik, in medicine, philosophy, poetry, and so on. So, physics is Ibn Sina, Avicenna. Abu Bakr Razi, in this science, he is from a city called the Rai in Iran nowadays. Listen, medicine, chemistry, metallurgy. He had a book called Kitab al-Hawi in medicine, 30 volumes. Kitab al-Jami', another one. And he contributed heavily to humanity. There was no division, no distinction, no marginalization. One ummah, one purpose. Tabari from Tabaristan, he was a Jew, and he was a doctor, a medical doctor, and he was a medical doctor and an engineer. You know, in his book called Firdaus al-Hikma, Firdaus al-Hikma, he put the basic principles of the general health. Then, how can you keep your health in a good state? He talked about muscles disease. He described fever. And he described the growth of the child. And started pediatric medicine. And he started to write the symptoms of the lung and chest disease. And he started to prescribe the poisons and the pharmaceutical medicine. He was the teacher of Al-Razi. Beside that, he had contribution in mathematics and in the calligraphy. Tabari, this one was not actually a Muslim, was a Jew. Abu Lufa al-Buzjani, Abu Lufa Muhammad ibn Yahya ibn Muhammad ibn Muhammad ibn Muhammad ibn Muhammad ibn Yahya ibn Ismail ibn al-Abbas al-Buzjani from Khurasan, again. What he did, first of all, spherical trigonometry. Spherical trigonometry. This is number one. And one of the most famous mathematician. Also has good contribution to astronomy. And he was the founder of astronomical observatory. Astronomical observatory, when we can look at the stars and the movement of the stars. Pure mathematics, contribution, pure mathematics. Okay? And the West talk from him. Okay? Abu Lufa al-Buzjani. Abu Rayhan al-Bayroni, another one from Uzbekistan, he was a student of Avicenna or Ibn Sina. They called him Ptolemus al-Arab or Arab Ptolemy. He was talking about the cycle or the movement of Earth. He was in physics, he talked about the speed of light. Geography, he drew the horizontal and longitudinal ones and put the theory for what? To measure and draw half of the circumference of the Earth. Half of the diameter and the circumference of the Earth to measure it. Plus, he was a poet, philosopher, and others. This was Abu Rayhan al-Biruni. He talked also about specific gravity of certain metals, such as gold, silver, and so on. He was from where? From Uzbekistan. Abu Ma'shar al-Balkhi, of course, Balkhi means Khorasan, means this area of Central Asian Republic. He was one of the most famous scientists in astronomy. He wrote about 30 books. Talk about astrology. Talk about cycle of stars and moon and others. And this is him, Imam Abu Ma'shar al-Balkhi. Al-Khazin, Abu Ja'far Muhammad ibn al-Husayn al-Khazin Khurasani, again Khurasani, which is this same area between Iran and Central Asian Republic. He put a theory about the shape of Earth and its composition. And he was the first one to talk about that objects, when it falls, it falls downwards. Before Isaac Newton, before Isaac Newton. But nobody recognized him. Everybody is recognizing Isaac Newton. He explained the star movement. And he put a equation to measure, or to actually to calculate the beginning of Hijri year, which is today or tomorrow or after tomorrow. And he wrote a lot of books. This is Al-Khazin. Scientist Al-Khazin. Al-Idrisi, of course, every one of you know him. He is from Andalusia. And he is the one who put the science of drawing, the geography, sorry, a science of geography and drawing the maps for the whole world. Al-Idrisi. Another one from Tus, Imam Nasruddin al-Tusi. He was originally from Khorasan as well. He was measuring with astrolabe. Astrolabe is this device which used to measure the movement of stars. And after the fall of Baghdad in the hand of the Mughal, he cleverly convinced Hulako to build this astronomical observatory. Astronomical observatory. And they managed to collect in it 400,000 book and document to keep it there. He was specializing in astronomy, algebra, mathematics, medicine, geography, manner, music, biology, chemistry, physics, and fiqh, jurisprudence. Okay? الفارابي أبو نصر محمد بن محمد بن أزلغ بن طرفان الفارابي كازاخستان as well and died in Damascus. His specialty metaphysics, medicine, music, politics, philosophy and others. This is a simple, very very simple contribution. Very simple contribution to humanity by those people who contributed to not only to Islam, to humanity. In pharmacy, three people from Andalusia. Ibn Wafid, okay, and he was a scientist and a minister and wrote a lot of things. Okay? And for 20 years, he was writing one book, encyclopedia, called the Book of Pharmaceutical Medicine. 20 years. Not somebody making his PhD in is or are or we or did or done or tomorrow in 6 months or a year or two because he cut and paste. And he's from Andalusia, from Tlaytela. Ibn al-Bitar also Jaladdin Abu Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Ahmad al-Maliki ibn al-Bitar from Andalusia as well. He is the first one, and this, listen to this, to use photochemical therapy. Photochemical therapy. Tell the doctors who are using this photochemotherapy today. This was Ibn al-Bitar from Andalusia. Okay? He was born in Malaga, but he died in Damascus because he was trying to live his life to search for knowledge. Okay? And he was so adamant about experimental medicine, he died, unfortunately, when he was experimenting on some plants, and he was poisoned by such plants. Abu al-Abbas, Ibn al-Rumiyyah, who al-Abbas, Ahmad ibn Muhammad ibn Mufarraj ibn Abi al-Khalil al-Ashbili, Andalusia again, he was one of those great scholars of pharmaceutical medicine. In medicine nowadays, they call about Ibn al-Batriq. He was an Egyptian Christian. But he was a scientist, a great scientist. He wrote the history of Ibn al-Batriq at that time. Ibn Rushd, every one of you knows Ibn Rushd. You know Ibn Rushd, but you know him about philosophy only or about theology. He wrote, he's from Andalusia, as you understand. He wrote more than 108 book. Okay? He's from Cordoba, Andalusia. Medicine, Islamic medicine, astronomy, philosophy, geography, mathematics, physics, Islamic science, and so on. But we always talk about Ibn Rushd on his fiqh and the philosophy to divide the community. Abu al-Faraj al-Yabrudi, Abu al-Faraj Gergis ibn Yuhanna ibn Sahl ibn Ibrahim al-Yabrudi, he's a Christian as well, but he has contribution under the great state which allowed everybody to contribute. Ibn Batlan again, another Christian. Okay, Abu Anis al-Mukhtar ibn al-Hasan ibn Abdun ibn Sa'dun ibn Batlan in Baghdad. You know what? He was the first one to use music for treatment. And he was a Christian scientist living in Baghdad at that time. Ibn Zahr al-Ashbili, Ashbilia, which is a part of Andalusia. Okay, and he was a minister as well as, no, he was a philosopher, a medical doctor, a poet as well. No, this is not the minister, okay? Abu al-Qasim al-Zahrawi, of course, everyone should know him because he wrote Encyclopedia Medica of 30 volumes, invented many, many instruments, and my thesis was about Abu al-Qasim al-Zahrawi. Also, he's from Andalusia. Yuhanna ibn Masawi, this is another Christian from Khuzestan, and he was very fond of anatomy, dissecting the body, and he started to do this dissection on monkeys. You know why? Because he knew that monkey body is very close in anatomy to human being. And this was Yuhanna ibn Masawi Al-Khawzami, who was a Christian from Khuzestan, nearby Baghdad. Then he was talking about ophthalmology. He wrote a book about ophthalmology. Okay? Two books about the diseases, about the treatment as well. Ibn Tuma also was another Christian in Baghdad to leave behind him 40 books. ابن سقلاب اللي هو موفق الدين ابن يعقوب بن سقلاب المشرقي, another Christian from Jerusalem. Okay. His geniusness, pioneering, it is experimental medicine. Experimental medicine. Long time ago. 1,228 years, he was born in 556 Hijri, died 625 Hijri. But experimental medicine. Okay? Ibn al-Majusi, okay, another one. He is from Persia at that time. You know what he discovered? You know what he discovered, Ibn al-Majusi? The capillaries, which is a small artisan device, the capillaries. And describe them. And he described how to can take the renal or kidney stone out. All right? And he just told us that the baby comes out during labor, not become come spontaneous, but because of the contraction of the muscles there. And he described for the doctors aneurysm. You know aneurysm, when the artery, the blood vessel, become like a balloon. Okay? And he made the tonsils, extract them. Okay? And he said, it's very difficult to treat TB or tuberculosis. You know why? Because the continuous movement of both lungs. Al-Majusi. Okay? From Persia. Ibn al-Ghazzar al-Qayrawani, of course, Qayrawan, which is now what we call actually Tunisia. Okay? He was specialized in pediatric medicine and geriatric medicine. Pediatric for the children, geriatric for the elderly. Some of the most important things he left behind is, I'm just going to talk about something which we need nowadays. Pediatric medicine for children. Medicine of poor, for poor and for miskin. Medicine for old people. See, this was 898 and he died 979. Hijri is 285. Yani 1,200 years or 1,100 years before us nowadays. Medicine for the poor, medicine for the elderly, medicine for the miskin. Ishaq ibn Sulaiman al-Israeli, another one in Qayrawan, which is near, he lived in Qayrawan and he moved to Egypt. He was a doctor, medical doctor, he was a rabbi and he was a philosopher. Ibn Sanjun, another Andalusi from Andalusia, and so on. Ibn al-Muqashshar and so on. Why I keep saying all this? At that time, everybody was living together. So everybody was contributing to humanity. Even if there was a limited space of freedom in this area. These are not everybody, but these are the contribution of the people who originally, okay, could not be Arab, but they managed to master the Arabic language, to go through fiqh, to go through Arabic language, to go through theology and to go through science and to be pioneering from everywhere, from Andalusia, as far as Andalusia, to Central Asian Republic, border of China, and to the Middle East as well. Okay, next one, please. Nowadays, we are so extremely rich. You can imagine how much has been paid to buy such a star. More than 200 million euro. You make football to be a new religion and you worship the stars of football, which are the prophets, that she can follow them. See, this gold car, this all this kind of wealth which is spent, nobody tells you, don't enjoy the wealth you have. But we tell you, with the wealth you have a responsibility to build community, to build society, to spread knowledge, to respect science, to build civilization, not to waste the money on consuming or consumer goods. Look at this, the most expensive yacht, the most expensive car. What is this? What is this? What is this that we spend the money on? And what is that? What was that? A part of the contribution of people who used to walk from a country to a country, from a continent to a continent, from a town to a town, to seek knowledge in science and technology for authenticity of the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ and for literacy and for everybody. See how much we spend, the way we spend our money? See? It makes you sick. It makes us sick that we have people in Myanmar. If we spend, if we as rich people or rich states sat down with the Myanmar government and agree with them for accommodating this ethnic minority there, $1 billion to $2 billion, you could have entertained them and give them the citizenship. And this is what we do. See, what we have, our new prophets, Arab talent. Can I dance with you? Arab good talent, Arab idols. Now, if it is kids good talent, do we say that you don't have this kind of competition? Yes, you do. But as much as we have competition for this, as much as we need to have competition for science, technology, theology, values, morality, and so, and so, and so, and so, and so. We worship, you see, what we have. And we make our stars, our superstars, to be those, could be some of them are fake, because they don't build the community. See, the most expensive Christmas tree and most expensive part. What we need to do is to build universities, to build research centers, to build think tanks. Look at the great universities, Edinburgh, Glasgow, Harvard, Oxford, Cambridge, and others. Look at Al-Qayrawan and the good old days. Look at Al-Azhar. I mean, everybody's attacking Al-Azhar nowadays. Look at the old universities, Zaytuna and the other. Look at the great, actually, teaching in Morocco, the good old days in Fas and Meknès and other cities, and the contribution. Where are these kind of universities and research institutions? I remember the first and most expensive horse in the late 70s when I came here in UK, was bought for $10 million. And its name was Red Ram. $10 million 40 years ago. The most expensive sheep. What is this? We love sheep. We love animals. We respect them because Allah has created them to help us, to save us, to live on this planet. But not to spend all this money, actually, and to waste all this money. See, the largest meal, Guinness Book of Record. Guinness Book of Record, what? Rice and meat. Next, please. When we look at the difference, the big difference between the contribution of those people who are now suffering in their countries. But their great grandfathers have contributed to humanity hundreds and hundreds of years ago in Kyrgyzstan, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, Afghanistan, and we treat them inferiorly. Wrong. Wrong, wrong. Forgive them the chance to survive and breathe. They will bring the history back. But what we have the chance to build strong renaissance, civilization. But we drain our resources in a drench, unfortunately. Myanmar is one example. Syria, Yemen, Libya, Palestine, Iraq, Afghanistan, and the poverty in Africa, and the poverty in the rest of our countries. What we are doing with what God has given us as a trust to use for humanity, as well as some of it for ourselves. Tomorrow we'll talk about it in Arabic, inshallah. And Jazakum Allah khair. May Allah bless you for being very patient, because I talk about 5 or 6 minutes extra. But unfortunately, this subject needs hours and hours and hours. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Happy New Hijri year for all of you.